Good morning, everyone. I'm the Minister of Land, Infrastructure and Transportation of Korea. Today, I'll talk about the story of cities. According to UN, 70% of the world population will live in cities by 2050. Already, the urban population has almost doubled from 2.3 billion to 4.4 billion in 2020. In the past, people came to cities for survival or seek jobs to sustain living. And for the many of the people, city had the meaning of the new opportunity. But cities now play more diverse roles. They provide a place of living and hub for economic innovation and activities. Then, what roles will cities play in the future? That's the story of the cities and our common interest. Ever since humans started to use fire, energy has been the driving force for human civilization. Energy contributed to the progress in human civilizations and the industrial revolution. But energy also caused problems like pollution and natural disasters, and these days we are facing the challenge of the climate change. More than 70% of the global carbon dioxide emission comes from cities. Our use of energy for our living and progress is threatening our very existence on the earth. So, it's now the time for cities to change. But for cities to change, our way of thinking about cities should change either. It gives us a testbed where we experiment new ideas and find new solutions to urban problems. It gives us a channel for interacting with one another and with the city we live in. In Korea, the government has led smart city projects based on Korea's new development experiences and our information technology strengths. As Saudi Arabia builds smart cities in Neom and the Red Sea and introduces smart solutions to existing cities like Riyadh and Jeddah for smart renewal, I'd like to talk about the three transformations that smart cities will bring in. The first transformation will be the use of urban space. We commute to workplace during the weekdays and travel outside cities during the weekend, but we waste much of our energy and time on roads due to traffic congestion. Smart city can solve the problem by creating a compact city. In a compact and smart city, movements inside cities are streamlined. You can walk to your office or nearby parks in just 10 minutes, as you imagine in the Neom city model. You don't need a car to drive between the places. And the urban parks can become a carbon sink. Thanks to such concentration, the complexity can help reduce the energy use and waste in cities. Second transformation smart city will bring is urban mobility. The entire transportation network in a smart city will be built around people rather than cars. Public transit systems running on clean energies give diverse alternatives to automobiles and can raise public transport ridership. Promotion of electric vehicles and hydrogen fuel cell vehicles and expansion of the charging infrastructure will facilitate the transition to sustainable green mobility. More than anything else, Smart City will transform urban mobility by putting pedestrians prior to cars and by reducing the carbon emissions from the sector. Third, and the last transformation the Smart City will accelerate is the digital transition. With digitization, connected urban infrastructure will use and manage energy more efficiently. It can also monitor and track the waste in water and electricity use. Using the smart waste recycling system, we can reuse and recycle urban waste. Renewable energies and generous buildings can increase energy self-sufficiency in cities. Smart city will accelerate such digitization of urban management and digitization of our society. But there is one thing, and the most important thing, we should never forget. Technologies alone cannot innovate cities. Without people living in smart cities, all the transformations the smart city will bring in will mean nothing. That's why we should always put people at the center of smart city. To build a people-centered smart city, we should think about how to improve people's living in cities and increase participation of diverse groups and people to make that improvement. In Korea, there is a saying, it takes more than pearls to make a necklace. It means that it takes more than good ideas to build a good smart city. Given the theme of today's forum, I would like to emphasize the importance of public and private sector investment in cities. In case of Korea, the government provides funding for smart city projects and introduces laws and policies to promote the private sector investment. In the smart city strategies, Saudi Arabia announced 50 smart city initiatives in 9 areas. I am confident that Saudi's strategies will unleash creativity and innovation that will ensure a harmonious living between human and nature, a sustainable development in Saudi Arabia. After this forum, Minister Hogail and I will sign a new executive program to expand our areas of cooperation to smart cities and etc. I hope our cooperation under the program will help expedite smart city development in Saudi Arabia. Once again, I express my appreciation for the invitation to the forum, and I sincerely wish that our future smart city cooperation would improve our cities and deliver future prosperity in Korea and Saudi Arabia, both countries. Thank you.